Hello, everybody. Wherever you are, remember to follow the government's corona advice. Yeah, the government guidance in regard to corona is very important. So remember to social distance, remember to wear your mask, and remember to sanitize. Wakenya wenzangu, leo hii, I want us to confront the issue of clubs' homelessness. Yeah, the issue of football clubs in Kenya being homeless is one of the most disturbing issue over the years, and we must confront it, we must talk about it, and we must be real. Now, to have clubs, yeah, or to have a club that does not have a home ground, that is a disaster from the word go. From the beginning, such a club can never have money, can never have sponsors, can never have supporters, can never have anything. So when we talk of issues and problems and poverty within our Kenyan football in regard to football clubs, especially the Premier League clubs and the National Super League club, that is unheard of. A country where professional football teams have no club. Jesus Christ, this is unheard of. And it's an issue I have looked at for very many years, and it is an issue I want us to confront. Yes, you may not have the answer. Yes, we may not be able to find the answer right now, but it is an issue that we cannot ignore. It is an issue we must confront. For example, think about Gor Mahia. Imagine if Gor Mahia had a home stadium since 20 years ago in Kisumu. Tell me the number of fans that they would have. The fan base would be huge, The whole of Kisumu would attend home matches, Gor Mahia home matches in Kisumu. Let's talk about the future of Gor Mahia being based in Nairobi. Right now, when Gor Mahia is playing in Nairobi at Nyayo Stadium or at Kasarani Stadium, people will attend, but in all seriousness, they are not the real supporters of Gor Mahia. People go there to have fun, to enjoy the game, and that's why you see if Gor Mahia is playing against Everton, the stadium will be full. When Everton leaves, and now Gor Mahia will be playing Kariobangi Shark or another club, except when they are playing the derby, because when they are playing the derby, is AFC Leopard and Gor Mahia fans coming together kuonyesha ushujaa wao. So that's a total different issue. But look at the fixtures of Gor Mahia, yeah? Very few fans come. Again, look at AFC Leopard, yeah? A club that is over 50 years old, but still it struggles to bring even 2,000 fans, even sometimes 500 fans. This is not okay, and the root cause is what I'm talking about. Yes, football in Kenya has been heading to the wrong direction for far too long. Yeah, football in Kenya, in regard to football governance, in regard to the issues of football fans, in regard to consideration of all stakeholders in football, things have been wrong. Yeah, and this one is an issue of the of football leadership and the vision of Kenyan football. But on the issue of clubs having their own home ground and having their own fan base, this is an issue that we need to focus on, and it is an issue that we cannot ignore. Yes, things are bad. Yes, things are wrong. But the club fan base is number one thing. When you go to negotiate on the table with a sponsor, they will ask you, how many fans does your club have? How many fans attend your home game, and how many fans attend your away fixture? That alone is enough to tell a sponsor whether you are worth being sponsored or not worth being sponsored as a club. So for me, homeless clubs, which are most Kenyan clubs, apart from one or two, I don't think there's a club that has a permanent fixed. And when I'm not talking about ground, just a ground, kwenda kuchezea hapo manyasini and you call it ground. I'm talking of a football stadium. When you talk of football grounds in Europe, yeah, you are not talking of an area, yeah, a fenced area with the manyasi or astro like Kamtoyoyo. When you talk of a football ground, it comprises stadiums, yeah, stadium, football pitch, shops, all of that for a club, everything that a professional club need to call home. That is what a football ground is meant to mean in terms of professional football clubs. But I want to say this, about 18 clubs out of the Super League and the Premier League, about 18, that is over a half, That is close to, we have 18 Premier League club and we have 20 Super League club. But we know now Chamiriri got relegated, Ushuru gone as well. So we are talking about 18 and 18, 36 clubs. But we have over 18 teams based in Nairobi. Think about the future. Think about 50 years to come. Think about 20 years to come. How can we have over half of professional football teams based in Nairobi? Even if you divide the population of Nairobi to those clubs, it tells you those are clubs that have no future. Those are clubs that don't want to grow. Those are clubs that have no long-term plan. Those are clubs that are just thinking about now. Yeah. And that's why they are being taken by the federation and they cannot fight this war, because they are thinking just about now. But if they were thinking about the future, they would have a different outlook. But tell me this, 18 or more out of 36 club based in Nairobi. There's no stadiums in Nairobi. So how are these 18 clubs hoping to get their calendar, their fixture fulfilled? How are they going to, you know, to participate in their fixtures? That's why they fight to rent Machako Stadium, which also look like a cattle farm. So there are issues we must confront. And we must stop keep saying that when we talk, we are fighting the federation. When we talk, we are fighting the federation. No, we are confronting the issues the way they should be confronted. There are so many issues to be confronted, but that cannot change unless first the federation changes. Yeah, the federation does things differently. The federation governance, the leadership, the election, there are so many things to change. And that is the beginning of change. And then it cascades down to the professional clubs, to the grassroots clubs, so that the whole system can change. So therefore, for today, this is what I want to say. And I wanted to congratulate Wazito, because I know they have been looking, yeah, they have been looking to relocate and having their home matches in Narok. That is a brilliant move. And I want many other clubs to follow the same way, to think, where can they have fans? Imagine if AFC Leopard today has a home ground in Kakamega. My God, the fan base they would have, the sponsorship they would have, the finance that they would have, the money that would follow them. So I want them to think long term. Having an office in Nairobi called AFC Leopard and a ground there is nothing. They can relocate for the future. Let us focus on the future. That's what in Europe football clubs are based on. Future. But for now, I'm telling football clubs in Kenya, for them to get big sponsorship deal, they have to start thinking, have a plan for their home ground, have a plan for their football stadium, and they be serious about it. Sponsors will even sponsor a good vision, leave alone something that they can see. A good vision worth a lot of money. And that's why I'm saying, that's why today I decided to address this issue of homelessness in our Kenyan football clubs. A club without a home ground or a stadium is a homeless club. Which sponsor in his or her right mind want to sponsor a homeless club? No one. I leave you in peace. I'm gone.